pinpoint questions. Girls, tell me where specifically is the weirdest place that you personally, girls, have ever gotten the urge to make whoopee?
In the
No.
It's the
I'm not talking about is the weirdest location, the weirdest place.
Location. Yeah. I don't know.
Give me an answer, please. He said it was in the car on the freeway.
Name one of the three bears.
Yogi.
This man's flying airplanes for us.
Our top winner in the showcase is Gay. And our runner-up today is Jose. And the...
For me, it's a miracle.
Okay, you are a miracle, Max. Going for 200. I know. It's pathetic. It's just, I'm an old, horny woman, all right? All right. Give me a break. All right. Whew. For 200, the childhood prank known as a wet willy involves putting a wet finger in someone's what? Anywhere you want to put it, Max. All right. Ear? Wait a minute. No, no. This is a game. We're going for $200. Okay, the wet willy, you put it where? The ear, armpit, nose, or your belly button?
Childhood prank, a wet willy.
A wet willy. Uh-huh. The childhood prank known as a wet willy involves putting a wet finger in someone's what?
Fortunately, I never quite grew up. Would it suffice if I just gave you one? Would that suffice?
Go ahead.
That's my final answer.
I think he's saying ear. Ear.
Final answer.
It was good for me. You got it. Bye-bye.
500.
P.
Two P's.
Like to solve the puzzle, please?
All right.
Regis Philbin and Kelly Ripa.
No, I'm sorry. We can't accept that. And Lee, it's your turn. $400.
Why?
There is a why, yeah. George, you have $900. What do you want to do?
I'd like to buy a vowel, please.
Okay.
An eye.
Yeah, four eyes.
I'd like to buy one more vowel, Pat. An A.
Mm-hmm. There's one A. No more vowels.
I'd like to sell the puzzle, Pat.
Okay, go ahead.
Regis Philbin and Kelly Ripa.
Well, what do you think there? That's why, you know, it's good to have it. And he's shaking his head. Now, Shane. You have $3,850. You want to take another shot at it?
I'd like to solve the puzzle, okay. Please. Regis Philbin and Kelly Ripa.
No, that is not correct. Lee, it's your turn. Or you just want to go out? Oh. $500.
H.
Yeah, there's an H.
B.
There is a B. $450.
K.
There is a K. Lee, would you like to say what's up there?
Regis Philbin and Kelly Ripa.
No. George, you want to try to?
I'm trying to solve it, Pat.
Yeah.
Regis Philbin and Kelly Ripa.
There you go. Woo! Well, We had a Philbrin, we had a Philman, we had a Ripa. And you guys think you're so hot in the morning, huh?
In life for 400, please.
In common law, the age of this, signaling adulthood, is presumed to be 14 in boys and 12 in girls. Tom?
What is the age of consent?
No.
What is the age of consent?
No.
The five movie ratings in the United States are NC-17, R, PG, PG-13, and this one. Kareem.
What is X?
No. You went in the wrong direction. We were looking for a G rating, not an X rating. Remember, Kareem, this is a family show. Dana, pick again.
Try again.
A pool.
Name the most popular cereal.
Frosted Flakes.
Name a job that's dirty, but someone has to do it.
A plumber.
Try again.
Of course. Dirty. Gynecologist.
You married, Rocco?
Not yet. Couple months.
Yeah, I better check with her after this one. Yeah. Boy, your buddy's at work when this goes on TV. It's about the best answer I've ever heard. That's one of Rocco. You stunned the world with that one right there. I don't know if we're gonna have enough tape to show the whole thing, but pretty sure they do on YouTube.
You would complete this sentence. My husband is the first man I ever heard about who, what?
He lasts so long when he's being, he just keeps. Quit. No, he just keeps going. You know, I really can turn him on. But he doesn't turn off. He lasts. He's got, you know, he's thin, but he's strong.
Mom number three, what is there about your daughter that reminds you of yourself when you were dating?
Well, there's not too much that reminds me of myself when I was dating, except maybe she likes to park.
How long have you known this?
Oh, for at least 2 years.
Now, wait a minute.
I'm so nervous.
You had a funny line? No. Take a deep breath.
Give her a
now,
breath.
Now, I exhale. You have to exhale occasionally, you know.
I'm married. I know that.
You are? Okay.
And?
You live in?
Huntington Beach.
That's right. See, she got it right so far. She's all right. You live in Huntington Beach and you're married. What's his name? Oh, now listen. It'll be all right. How long you been married?
5 years.
5 years. Dave, have I got a girl for you?
We surveyed 100 people and asked them to name a way of toasting someone. Michelle.
Over a fire.
Tell you what, if it's up there, I'll give you the money myself. Over a fire. Oh, no! I owe you £12. That's the first.
Kirsty.
As in thirsty, huh? Where do you live?
I live in Wichita, Kansas.
Specifically, what is your address and phone number? Here we go for the big money now, Kirsty. Someone to blank.
I want someone to love.
Really?
Welcome to Bullseye. It's a very interesting description Charlie just made there. I play a little golf myself. How's the game these days?
Well, I'm real straight, but not real long.
Well, we all have our problems. I'm real long, but I'm not very straight. How about the... Well... X gets a square.
I saw him looking at your card.
Oh.
He looked back at your card. Get your card.
I knew the answer.
This has never happened before in the show. You all saw this? Lisa, could you, maybe our producer would like to come up here and you'd like to talk together.
I'm going
to go for a
Coke. Looking at the card.
Yeah.
No, wait just a minute.
Oh.
I'm leaning back like this and looking at the card.
Check, please.
I knew the answer. Right here.
I knew the answer.
N.
No N. Randy.
Mary Beth prayed for snow on her wedding day.
Yes, I did. It was 32 degrees and no snow on my wedding day, but I had 8 inches on my honeymoon. So.
Ladies, if the law said that all married men had to take a second wife, who would your husband make a play for? Niecy.
Antoinette.
Who?
Antoinette.
Who's that?
He got a baby by her.
Oh.
You always say it was an accident. Ain't nothing like that, no accident.
This ain't no soap opera.
It ain't no accident.
You know, you get off that now. He just asked you one name. That's
well,
all you're
telling. Well, I told him the name, and that ain't no accident, honey. Having a baby ain't no accident.
Could I see the card, please?
Man, she on drugs.
I know.
Sylvia Anderson, what do you do?
I'm a waitress, and I'm also a volunteer teacher's aide.
Do you like to play password?
I love it.
Would you like to do it? We're all going to do it. Here, let me play password, that is.
Gentlemen, other than popcorn, what is your favorite thing to nibble on at the movies? Steve?
I'm going to get shot. Her boobs. I don't know if you...
Bachelor number one, how does a girl earn a little star in your little black book?
When she puts her hand in my pocket and grabs my rocket and then shoots the stars.
I don't believe so.
Name something that has to warm up before you use it, sir.
How about your wife?
Your favorite thing to do to torture your parents?
Actually, my mother was Welsh and my father was Hungarian, which makes me well hung. But anyway, so...
Kitty, how did you vote?
I went for number two. I don't think a bird like that would cost $50 to $200, even though he can talk a little bit.
Okay. Bill Cullen.
Well, you know, we have a rule on this show that if we have seen some of the people on the show, whether they're right or wrong, we can question but not vote. Well, I have to disqualify myself because I met one of those gentlemen in the men's room, which,
What does that get to do with this?
Well,
I want you to know where I met the man. Because you might...
How do you answer Kitty's question?
How'd you know he was the real one?
He had his bird in his hand.
I would
if
say...
If it's there, you win, Lacey.
Name a something. Hot guy.
You'd be next to a hot guy.
Yeah. Or a hot person.
Or a hot person. This is great.
I love hot chocolate, by the way.
You like hot chocolate?
Yes.
I like marshmallows in my hot chocolate. Can't play with me. This is what I do.
This is
God, I'm not gonna have a marriage. I love my wife so dearly. Here we go. We're looking for a hot thing next to you sitting.
Let me hear your best impersonation of a drum. Bachelor number three. How do you stop a girl from snoring?
Punch her in the mouth. Usually.
Wife said you are a closet what?
She's not. Closet freak.
Closet freak. Hang on, Charlie. She said you're a...
Let me see.
What O is the generic word for any living animal or plant, including bacteria and viruses?
Orgasm. Oh.
Now, we welcome you and ask you to tell us about yourself.
I live in Orange County. I'm retired.
I'm gonna go with B, kilobytes.
Final answer?
Final answer.
I'm a fat man, Regis. My heart can't take it.
I'm just trying to help you sweat off a few pounds.
Name? A specific part of the body that women try to accentuate.
Sabre.
Breasts.
Secretary who's driven in 5 presidential motorcades.
Wow.
Well, I did Clinton 2 different trips. And...
One for each?
Never mind.
Beautiful.
And Bob. Now, Jimmy. Don't you think the winner is getting $5,000?
Come on, Bob.
Let's meet an African explorer.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Peter Agababi Palangian.
Number two.
My name's the same as his.
What do you get when you cross a 70s band with a carload of dwarves? Simple, folks. You get... You're gonna like this. The Village Little People!
Young man, there's no place you can go. I said, young man, when you're short on your dough, you can stay there. And I'm sure you will find you will have a good time.
It's fun to stay.
We have to introduce another player, and with a great deal of pleasure, we present Karen Lesko. Hi, Karen.
Hi.
You know John?
Yes, we do.
Doesn't she have pretty nipples, pretty dimples there?
Maybe the longest first $1,000 game we've ever had.
Gilbert Gottfried.
Gilbert Gottfried! Gilbert, Playgirl Magazine's clinical sexologist, says, I think we should be able to talk about sex the way we talk about what?
I'm gonna say food.
I'll disagree.
Food. All right, now, Valerie, where are you going?
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
Surprise. Okay. Gilbert, in a poll, 94% of Hungarians, compared to only 46% of Americans, said doing this was necessary to feel fulfilled.
Having a child.
I disagree.
You fool!
Having a child is correct, David.
Oh, my goodness!
David? Gilbert Gottfried. Gilbert Gottfried! When she heard that Phileas Fogg had done it in 80 days, journalist Nellie Bly beat him by doing it in 72 days. What did she do?
This is rowing the Atlantic.
I'm gonna agree.
You fool!
Gilbert Gottfried for the win!
The tube top!
I agree!
You fool!
David, back to you!
Gilbert Gottfried.
It's the last perfect pitch game.
I'm gonna agree.
You fool!
Valerie, your turn.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
For the win.
The Crusher.
I'll agree.
You fool!
All right, Officer Dave.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win. The word smog comes from what two words?
Smoke and fog.
Smoke and fog.
I'm gonna agree.
Smoke and fog!
A famous male dancer.
Betty Grable.
Gentlemen, tell me, what is your favorite part of our newlywed game set? Jim?
Probably wife number two.
Name of food people give as a gift.
Lasagna.
Well, name a place where you would see lots of flowers.
At the zoo.
All right.
What will your husband say is the one thing he absolutely forbids you to put on his wiener?
Ben Gay.
Name something you buy and then have to be careful about how you carry it home.
An infant.
An infant. Something you buy.
Oh, buy!
Or one possession that your husband wishes you'd be more careful about hiding when the two of you have visitors. Cindy.
I know what his is, but mine? I would his vibrator, I guess.
Oh, all right. Jim said it would be...
It's yours.
Now, who's it belong to?
Him.
Whoever gets the most usage.
I see, never mind.
His.
That's still working across the hall from you, Les?
Yes, she is.
You believe a woman should work after she's married?
No, but I believe it's only right until we get a little money ahead in case of a sudden little mishap.
Thank you.
mean by that, Les. Well, I hope you don't mean what they think you mean.
Different things can arise.
Product you manufacture, would you be apt to find this in the living room or the dining room or the kitchen?
Well, you can't answer that question.
Well, she
yes
must make something.
No.
A woman can't make a living just being a blonde. Although I've heard of a few who have.
Hey, did you hear that Ronald McDonald has his picture in Playgo magazine?
No.
Yeah, let me tell you about it. They got a great shot of his blank.
Quarter pounder.
Joan, when Sir Henry Curtis and Alan Quatermain traveled over the mountain range known as Sheba's Breasts, what were they looking for?
I imagine the Silicon Valley.
Grandpa's getting pretty old. Last night he put his false teeth in my milk. Milk is the answer that Myron's looking for. Let's see if we get a little milk from Patty here. Then.
I beg your pardon.
Clean it up, Richard.
I'd like 2 quarts in the morning.
Girls, why did the two of you make whoopee when you did for the very first time? Sharon?
I was horny. I still am.
You still are.
Let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. All right, let's start this time with Joni.
Is it a useful thing?
Yes.
Would you say that a man can get pleasure from this, too? Could you use one of these to squeeze a...
Now, these things smoke up when they get overheated. When they're worn out, can they be restuffed?
No, Meredith. The gentleman's name is A. Nade.
Oh, I have it right here.
Next question, ladies. 25-point boner. Bonus question. Say is his least favorite thing to find in his pasta.
I just throw gravy on old shoes and throw them on the table. He'll eat anything.
You call that soul food, right?
Yeah.
Describe for Patty these things associated with yogurt.
It's got stuff that's good for your bones.
Calcium.
Uh-huh. And, it's...
Culture?
Eli, what's the worst thing a player can do in your favorite sport?
Well, my favorite sport is playing basketball.
What's the worst thing a player can do?
I guess it would be the worst thing not to throw, you know, not to have my English, I'm telling you, it's a little bit hard. My Spanish is better.
Well, go ahead and tell me in Spanish.
I don't speak Spanish at all.
We asked 100 women, name something women borrow from each other. Chris.
One another's husbands.
Their husbands, Chris.
You never know, right?
You never know?
Never know.
You think that made the survey?
No.
I'm playing my...
Tambourine?
Yes. I take wrap rubber bands around my t-shirt and stick it in...
Tie-dye?
Yes. These are the ugly sandals that lesbians wear.
Birkenstocks.
Yes.
Veronica, I understand that at one time you wanted to become a mortician.
He made me quit. My husband.
Why?
Well, he didn't appreciate my sense of humor. I put an ear in his lunch one time because we got in an argument. And...
Our top winner in the showcase is Gay. And our runner-up today is Jose. And what's your bid, Jose, on this showcase?
I've been on the showcase, you mean everything?
Everything.
Everything.
Give me your bid, Joe. Jose, what do you bid?
I bid $250,000.
$250,000? Think about that for a moment now.
Woo! Wait.
$60,000. That your bid? $60,000 it is. Gay? This is your showcase.
Gay, your showcase can be yours if the price is right.
All right, Gay, what do you bid on your showcase?
$1.
$1 is your bid. The audience approves. We'll be back after this. Oh, excitement is running hot. Gay, you bid $1 on your showcase. Actual retail price of her showcase, $28,898, a difference of $28,897. Now over to Jose. Jose, you bid $60,000 on your showcase. Actual retail price of Jose's showcase, $20,685. You win, baby. You win. Who's over?
Don't try to make up.
Dr. Jekyll has a new potion. Instead of turning into Mr. Hyde, he turns into blank. Dr. Jekyll has a new potion. Instead of turning, as he drinks it. Then instead of turning into Mr. Hyde, he turns into blank.
Wait a minute.
Spelling doesn't count.
You bet.
No, but I don't think there's a nine in any word.
Nine. All right, everybody's ready, Chris. Dr. Jekyll has a new potion. Instead of turning into Mr. Hyde, he turns into...
Cinderella.
Isn't that sweet?
He lives in Sweden, huh?
Isn't that a sweet answer?
Wow. It certainly is.
Cinderella is her answer.
Tell me the time of the next pumpkin.
Bill, what did you say?
Well, he just made a little mistake in the potion.
Yeah.
And he turned into Mrs. Hyde.
Mrs. Hyde. All right, Brett.
I couldn't resist it. I haven't said it for so long. He turned into a fag.
Oh, I see. Right. In two or three.